that we were talking about, although we had mentioned Madison at that point, but a guy who can move, a defensive back, and let's make no mistake about it, Bobby Greer, I mean, he really has the say in the selection, but you like that fit, Joe and Mel?
I do. I think he's a very quick football player. I mean, you look at his abilities, first team All-American, Big 12 Defensive Player of the Year, 14 career interceptions. Not real big, but look at his quickness. See the feet? I mean, very physical for a little guy that has the ability to even adjust his face mask twice before he goes on to play. Good adjustment to the ball. Comes up, supports real well in the corner. A lot of little guys aren't inclined to want to do that. This little guy has the ability to do it. Again, nice job. Take out the big guy and the little guy and force the fumble. Has a lot of versatility. I like him. Even though he's a small guy, I think he has a real physical nature to his play. And again, that's what Pete Carroll likes. He likes guys who can get physical and also move on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, an all-time record, by the way, for underclassmen that have gone in the first round. As we take a look, we've never had this many guys come out early. 13. Remember, the Packers are still on the clock. They could do the same thing. So 13 underclassmen here, which is why Mel, in his Bible, in his best-selling 1997 draft report, that's why he has not only next year's class, but the sophomore class, the freshman class, the eighth grade, the junior high, excellent players.
I mean, you got everybody. Really, these kids, it trickles up. I mean, the young kids, they move up. So the sophomores are going to be juniors. There's the kids that are going to be involved in next year's draft potentially. And you have to let the fans out there know who these guys are early. Certainly, when you look at Chris Canty, the pick by New England, one of the more confident players in this draft. And as you mentioned, when you're small, you better run well. It took his third 40 time during an individual workout to get under 4.5. And that's what allowed him to move from maybe an early to mid two into the late first round and be a possibility for the New England Patriots.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the defending champion Green Bay Packers are on the clock. Last time a Super Bowl champ stayed pat, didn't move up or down, was 91. Now, you're looking at the Packers war room, and I think they would like to upgrade their defense. I think they would like to upgrade the defensive line. Mike and Ron Wolf have an interesting choice. I'm going to throw out a name that they haven't, the Wisconsin fans don't know about this school. Marcellus Wiley, defensive end, Columbia. Why not?
First coming into the league, you're at the bottom of the mountain.
Football camp is the hardest thing I've ever been through.
Team, coaches, media, all eyes are looking at me.
Your whole body just starts getting hot.
We asked some of the NFL's hottest rookies to switch antiperspirants and try Degree.
Body heat activated.
As your body heat rises, Degree releases extra protection when you need it most.
As I work harder, Degree works harder.
This stuff really works.
When your temperature rises, here it is, Degree.
Body heat activated Degree for an extra degree of protection.
It helped me keep my coolness.
Leonard Russell of the Chargers is one of the best I ever had. The only thing he needed to learn was discipline. I think it's pretty simple. You pay attention to your coaches, you act like a gentleman off the field, and you respect your elders.
The NFL's High School Coach of the Year program salutes Don Norford as Coach of the Year.
Didn't I tell you to call your father?
Girls earn their wings every day.
Hooters, it's not just a restaurant, it's an adventure.
Unleash the beast. Unleash the beast. Yeah! Walkie's master.
Luxottica eyewear. What do you want people to see?
I want you to see a student and a teacher.
See refinement. I'd like you to see me. Luxottica eyewear. Let them see you.
All right, the pack, after a wait of what? Of over 5 hours to get on the horn. The 30th pick in the final pick in the opening round. And also been waiting. Oh, my goodness, is he waiting to throw a pass here. Let's go up to Gary Danielson on the frozen tundra. Gary?
Chris, really, the philosophy here for the Packers is that we aren't last, we're really first. And the way they're looking at it is from now on, throughout the rest of this draft, the Packers will choose in front of the Jets. And with the track record Ron Wolf has had here in late rounds, behind me, the jersey of Dorsey Levens is sitting right there, a very effective football player. Other guys like Leroy Butler, Frank Winters, Mark Chimura have all been late round picks, and only five players on the Super Bowl team for this Packer teams were originally drafted in the first round by the Packers. An interesting dilemma for the Packers, though. They've lost a lot of speed on offense, but defensively, with Wayne Simmons and Sean Jones probably not coming back, and Randy White a little bit older, which way do you go? Remember, a year ago, John Michaels fell into their lap. Could it be someone like a Ross Verba from Iowa still sitting there that Ron Wolf chooses right now? Chris?
All right, Gary, thank you. The Packers have about 9 minutes to make their selection. Offseason, have with you the champs this day and age, you get rated. They lost Desmond Howard, the kick returner extraordinaire. Andre Rison was in late, then gone. I mean, in later in the year, and what a job he did. Jim McMahon, well, they've got Steve Bono to be the backup to Brett Favre. Coordinator Kit Jackson is going to be on a competitor. Heaven forbid. They've re-signed a lot of guys. But I think a guy that holds the key to how they do next year is a guy they lost very early, Robert Brooks. All signs are that his knee is doing fine. And if he can step back, then they're okay with Brooks and Antonio Freeman after the job that he did, and Don Beebe. They think they're okay there. Robert Brooks is one of the guys that holds a key how his rehab is going. Let's go to Mark Malone. Let's get back to the Rod Woodson discussion. You said if the Steelers sign someone else at corner, Rod Woodson will be done in Pittsburgh. Is it over?
Well, I don't know, Boomer. I just got off the phone with Steeler personnel and people in the front office. They're not completely ruling out that Rod Woodson would not be back. They only had a certain amount of money under the cap to offer this guy. I think Woodson's latest proposal was something that was close to what he made in his last year of his last deal. So obviously there's less money in the kitty. The Steelers say that they will evaluate this after the draft, and they'll take a look at it. Maybe they can have him back, but certainly this might spell the end for Rod Woodson in Pittsburgh. As for Donnell Wolford, a guy who's had a couple of incidents, DUI, the Steelers say that he's been checked randomly for the last 3 years by the NFL, and he's been clean. They don't think he's got a problem with alcohol or anything else. They believe Donnell Wolford has at least thinks he's got a bad rap. He fits into their plans. He's excited about being there, so the Steelers feel real good now. They've got a veteran quarter, and they've got Chad Scott, who fits right into their plans, big physical guy that can separate people from the ball and tackle. So they're feeling pretty comfortable, and I think Rod Woodson at this point might be on the outside looking in. It'll be very interesting to see how this thing turns out, Boomer.
Well, it would be a shame, as we said to Mark, to see Rod Woodson and the Steelers part ways. We shall see. We do know, as Andrew reported, that Donnell Wolford now a four-year deal with the Pittsburgh Steelers. So, I mean, I talked, Joe, about Robert Brooks. I mean, he could take a receiver here, but really, D-line and linebacker, and even secondary to a lesser degree, I think is where he's looking.
I think the D-line has really got to be the area that the Packers look at. I mean, there's age in that defensive line. Reggie White's at 35, Santana Dotson at 27, Gilbert Brown at 26, Gabe Wilkinson 25. And you say, well, geez, Joe, you got a bunch of those guys in their 20s. Well, the case is that Reggie White is the one that I think you have to look at moving on. If you get a shot at a good defensive lineman here, I think it's a perfect place to do it. The Green Bay Packers are in all likelihood going to be picking this far in drafts for quite a while now, at least the next 2-3 years, I'm figuring, so that if they can just fill in another young defensive lineman to go with those middle 20 guys, then they're ensuring the opportunities to be able to have stability there. And we know Fritz Schirmer is a magician when it comes to working with defenses, and I personally think that if he can get an older, a younger guy there to replace Reggie, it takes a little bit of the pressure off what they want to do up front.
Under 6 minutes now on the clock for the Green Bay Packers. Wayne Simmons looks like he's gone, almost definitely gone. So let's look at outside linebackers, Mel.
Well, there's some good ones still available. Certainly we saw James Farrier go 8th overall to the Jets. Jamie Sharper, his teammates, good value at this point. Jason Taylor, better suited for a 3-4. Same thing with Greg Jones, more of a 3-4 outside linebacker from Colorado. Mike Hamilton, I like him as a sleeper from North Carolina A&T. Thomas just dropped. Singleton, Sharp, and Mitchell figure in that 2-4 area.
Well, I mean, the Packers could be entertaining calls right now to see if somebody wants to come up, although to get pay first-round money for really a second-round kid, it's hard to imagine a team, unless they have one particular guy in mind, to make this move.
Well, That's what you want at this stage. You're looking for, I think, a great value pick. Sharper would be Sam Madison. There's some corners out there. There's Jerry Wunsch and Ross Verba. Gary mentioned Verba. Jerry Wunsch from Wisconsin's a good player. And went Michaels last year from USC. They have a lot of options. I think they're probably a little surprised that some of these good football players are still there.